Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Dr. Neeti Goyal, Assistant Professor, Department of Commerce, Indira Gandhi National College, Ladwa, District Kurukshetra. Today we are going to discuss multiculturalism and human resource management, managing diversities. Learning outcome. After completing this module, the students will be able to know the meaning of culture, forms of research in international human resource management, theoretical contributions to cultural diversity, advantages and challenges, and approaches to manage cultural diversity. One of the most difficult challenges for an international resource manager, international human resource manager, is to cope up with the cultural diversity among employees. Cultures vary significantly from one nation to the other and from one organization to the other. And MNC employs people from all over the world with diverse cultural backgrounds. Cultural differences make variances in people's values, beliefs, and behavior patterns, in a sense, what they consider to be right or wrong, normal or not normal, etc. Cultural affects the way we develop and maintain relationships. These differences often contradict each other. The problem becomes when people have strong belief in their own culture and consider it to be more superior over the other's culture. Employees often are not sensitive to cultural differences and hence are often mistaken by other persons' acts. Understanding of cultural effects is more important than any other aspect of the business. Knowledge about and competency in working with varying country and organizational cultures is one of the most important issues impacting the success of international business activity in general and of international human resource management in particular. The impact of differences in national and organizational cultures lie at the center of every aspect of international business and IHRM. Cultural diversity impacts attitudes, manners, and perceptions of the individuals. Cultural diversity results in differences in qualities of groups and individuals, which in turn affect the workers' sense of identity in the organizations and their way of perceiving each other. The differences in management style, organizational attitude, patterns, behavioral characteristics, and communication style. It also affects international business activities as cross-national negotiations, sale interactions between people from different countries, management of the performance of employees from different countries, the understanding and treatment of contracts between firms from different countries, and all HR responsibilities such as recruiting and hiring, compensation, training, labor relations, and performance management. Thus, cultural differences make huge implications. The general philosophy of employees with limited international experience is that they expect that the similar business methods and practices would be in other countries as they do at home. However, this is not practical. Such positive overlap is rarely possible. The success or failure of international assignment depends on how one deals with the cultural differences. What is culture? In simple words, culture is what we do and how we do. Culture is our routine of sleeping, bathing, dressing, eating, and getting to work. It is our household cores and actions we perform on the job, the way we buy goods and services. It is the way we greet friends or address a stranger, and even to a larger extent, what we consider right or wrong. According to Hofstede, culture is the collective programming of the mind, which distinguishes the members of one group or category of people from another. Others assert that culture entails not just shared interpretations of behavior, but also actual differences in behavior. Culture is the characteristic way of behaving and believing that a group of people have developed over time and share. It is very difficult to define culture. It can be said to be composed of several layers. An attempt has been made to clarify the meaning of culture through the three-layer model or the onion model, shown in figure 1, which depicts culture as a three-layered structure representing less visible or implicit values and assumptions as we move from outside to inside. These layers include surface or explicit culture, which is the outside layer. It depicts the aspects that are readily observable, such as clothing, food, aesthetics, norms, body language, mannerism, rituals, decorums, etc. Hidden culture, which is the middle layer, the second layer of the model, depicts the values and the philosophies and religion. It depicts the views, beliefs, perceptions. It may include the ways of grooming a child, beliefs of what is right and wrong, good or bad. Implicit or invisible culture is represented by the core of the onion. The truth about the culture. This is the most important aspect of culture, which needs to be understood by the HR manager, as an understanding of this aspect helps manager prepare employees for international assignments or developing international compensation and motivation practices. Figure 2 depicts below the cross-cultural competency. As people develop an ability to work successfully with differing cultures, they typically go through a process in figure 2. Development of cross-cultural competence. It depicts that to know about another person or group's behavior and values, and for integrating with their behaviors and attitudes, require one to understand her or his own cultural values and beliefs, through which he can develop a respect for cultural differences. This ladder will eventually lead to reconciliation and integration of cultures. All the three stages are challenging. All three stages require progressing from basic education and training about own culture and cultures of others, experiencing with other cultures to reflect on, and then developing an openness about different cultures, and finally a willingness to seek feedback about own values and behaviors in relation to foreign culture. Forms of research in international human resource management. Research in international human resource management can take three forms. These are cross-cultural research. Cross-cultural research aims to study HR issues or practices by comparing one country to another. Multicultural research. Under this, HR practice or issue in a number of countries are studied. HR practices in other countries. It describes human resource practices in one or more countries that are unfamiliar to the researcher. Theoretical contributions to cultural diversity. There are many theoretical contributions to an understanding of cultural diversity. They provide an understanding of some common categories in which culture can be categorized. It can greatly befit the firm working within the multicultural environment. Hofstede's model and cultural dimensions by Hall. Hofstede model. Geert Hofstede, a Dutch scholar and the best known researcher in this field, has given 5D model to identify, classify and compare cultures. The various cultural dimensions in Hofstede's study are: power distance represents the inequality among people. Lesser power distance means less inequality. As power distance increases, there are greater status and authority differences between supervisors and subordinates. Power distance in a nation affects the reactions to management authority. Power distance affects management's attitude towards participative management or autocratic approach. Individualism, the extent to which people in a country prefer to act as individuals instead of members of groups. Asians tend to be less individualistic and more group oriented, whereas those in United States score the highest in individualism. In cultures with high individualistic tendencies, promote individual competition, and with less individualistic tendencies, more collective action. masculinity or femininity. The cultural dimension of masculinity or femininity refers to the degree to which masculine values such as assertiveness, performance orientation, success and competitiveness prevail over feminine values, which are quality of life, close personal relationships and caring. This dimension might affect the roles which are assigned to women expatriates in the various countries. Uncertainty avoidance. The dimension of uncertainty avoidance refers to the preference of people in a country for structured rather than unstructured situations. A structured situation is one in which rules can be established and there are clear guides on how people are expected to act. Nations high on this factor tend to be more resistant to change and more rigid, while others are more flexible. The factor of uncertainty avoidance affects the reactions of people to changes. Those with uncertainty avoidance behavior get uncomfortable with the sudden changes, but those with flexible cultures take changes as challenges and face with it more zeal and spirit and promote entrepreneurship. Long-term orientation. The long-term orientation deals with society's research for righteousness. In societies with long-term orientation, people show an ability to adapt traditions according to changed conditions and determination in achieving results, as opposed to short-term values where focus on present and past, which include respecting tradition and fulfilling social obligations. Cultural dimensions by Hall. Edward Hall stressed the close relationship between culture and communication. He defined culture as a system to provide, send, store information. Edward Hall developed a useful way to understand culture by identifying their social framework as low or high context. Context can be best defined as the array of stimuli surrounding a communication event, including gestures, tone, physical distance between conversationists, time of the day, weather, situation. For example, during a war commemoration ceremony, societal norms, graphic place of communication, and other external factors. High context and low context cultures are differentiated by the emphasis that is given to the context against the actual message itself. According to Hall, in high context cultures, emphasis is placed on the implicit messages rather than the explicit message. If there is a contradiction between the verbal and the non-verbal aspect, non-verbal aspect is relied and acted upon, whereas in low context culture, much attention is paid to the actual message rather than the stimuli surrounding the message. In case of contradiction between the non-verbal and verbal message, verbal messages are relied upon. Information is explicitly known rather than implicit. Low context cultures emphasize speed, accuracy, and efficiency in communication. A lean message is preferred. In low context cultures, a concrete meaning is expected rather than abstract meaning. Within the framework of context, one finds a subset of cultural categories based on time. All cultures either have a monochromatic or polychromatic sense of time. Low context cultures tend to be monochromatic. In polychromatic cultures, many things go on at once. Polychromatic cultures tend to be high context. Advantages and challenges of cultural diversity. Advantages of cultural diversity. Multicultural workforce though difficult to manage, is advantageous for the organization. Some of the advantages of operating in a multicultural workforce environment have been discussed below. Variety of ideas. The first advantage of a multicultural workforce are the variety of ideas. Since the workforce is from different cultural backgrounds, they have different perspectives of looking at the things, and they can provide multiple ideas about solving a problem. Second is the development of new product. In case of new product development, the workforce with different cultures can support the development of new product offering, which can be useful for a wide customer base. Third, if a firm employs multicultural staff, it gets a wide base of employees to choose upon the best talent. Also, staff retention will be better since no employee will feel out of place. Employees will give their best and are more knowledgeable about the customer base. Also, employees with different cultures can provide better understanding about the customers of different cultures, and hence customer base can get broadened. Fourth is drawing from the full pool of talent, both domestic and international. A diverse workforce means that employees are recruited from a wide pool of talent, and enhancing the prospects of recruiting the best employee for every available position in the organization, particularly when traditional labor pools are unable to deliver the required skills and numbers. All the above mentioned benefits help firm earn a competitive edge and helps the firm in building a better public image. Challenges of cultural diversity. First is increased training costs. When the workforce differs in behavior, thinking and attitude, they need to be given training so that they can better understand each other. Problem arises not with the verbal communication but the non-verbal aspect of it. As different cultures have different perspectives and norms, possibilities of misunderstanding increase, which can be done away with training only. Workforce can be made sensitive towards other cultures through training only. Second is increased incidence of conflicts. Conflicts arise due to disagreement on a particular situation, which is quite obvious when people from diverse backgrounds having different perceptions about different situations work together. Employees may have sensitivities towards their own culture and feel other cultures to be inferior to them. This may result in personality clashes and may result in derogatory comments or gestures. Low productivity. If diversity is not managed effectively, no system is developed to manage the diversity, employees may feel dissatisfied, which may affect their productivity and may also lead to higher attrition rates. Reverse discrimination. Reverse discrimination is a situation where the members of the majority may feel that their interests are ignored and minority are given preferential treatment over them because of their minority status and not their ability or qualification. Increase in costs. Member of diverse cultural backgrounds have different religious and cultural expectations. The company needs to accommodate such differences. Also, their different dietary needs and expectations, which definitely leads to increase in the cost of operation. Approaches to manage cultural diversity. It is difficult, not impossible, to manage cultural diversity. Some approaches which can help effectively are overcoming the stereotypes and increasing fairness. Cultural stereotyping should be overcome in the company. Cultural stereotyping here means when managers have the tendency to employ the people of their own culture rather than having a fair selection on the basis of their appropriateness for the job. The stereotypes may lead to discrimination against the minority employees. They may feel neglected or ashamed of their culture and hence may not cooperate. Stereotyping may spoil the entire company's culture and affect its profitability adversely. So, employees should be selected fairly on the basis of merit rather than on racial basis. recruitment and selection should be fair for all employees with different cultural backgrounds. The screening tools must be culturally sensitive. Completely evaluating diversity means treating people as individuals. In an efficient diversity management system, companies should pay attention to the contributions that the diverse workforce and unique individuals can make to the companies. Blending cultural diversity with a dominant organizational culture. Another strategy to manage cultural diversity is to make the culture of the company so strong that the cultural differences among the workforce get blended into the organizational culture and all employees experience equality in their organization. Organizational culture is a group of ruling ideas that include ways of reasoning, ways of action, common shared values, codes of conduct and ethical standards which are formed and developed over a long period. A common culture should be created in an organization in which individuals from different nations and different cultures can comfortably work together and where differences are not felt. There should be commonly shared values in the organization and all cultures should be led by one and only one corporate culture at the sufficient level. Dealing by a HR program or strategy. In order to manage the culturally diverse workforce, it is important to design HR programs and strategies. Significant responsibilities should be given to the human resource departments and modern management techniques should be utilized. In-service training programs must be designed so that the employees can learn about other people's culture, which will help in developing a better understanding towards people of different cultures and can help them become sensitive to other cultures. It will also help managers to understand how people from different cultures view work, how or by what they are motivated, what their attitudes are, what they value, etc. The increase of cultural diversity necessitates managers to possess the information and understanding about how to manage people who are very different from each other in order to reach their common goals. Managers in a culturally diverse workforce must use variable management techniques rather than a single technique. It is very important for employees to be trained interculturally regarding business. Conclusion. Human resources being the most important resources for any organization. An organization needs best employees to manage its diverse activities. The human talent is not restricted to any particular region or country. In order to employ the best talent, the organization has to break the shackles of the regional boundaries and has to recruit the best employees from all over the world, and hence its workforce may have employees from different cultures and backgrounds. These cultural diversities are important to manage, otherwise it can have serious implications. An adequate understanding of the culture and its impact on behavior is of utmost importance for an international human resource manager, as the cultural differences affects the perceptions and hence the actions and reactions as different cultures approach situations differently. An international HR manager must manage cultural diversities effectively, otherwise it could prove costly for the firm in terms of lower productivity, uncooperativeness and higher attrition rates. Thank you.